It's Tom and Todd's Face Off on WRKO.com. Brought to you by Chamonix, the science of beautiful skin.
Welcome to Face Off. You notice the Red Sox spring training, they need days and weeks. It almost seems like months to get ready. Todd and I, top of our game, every day for you. Face Off on WRKO.com.
Mitt Romney's advisors are downplaying a win in Michigan. But seriously, if Mitt can't win in his home state, doesn't this play into the storyline of the GOP not being sold on Mitt? Isn't it detrimental to his campaign?
There are people out there saying that if he loses Michigan, forget detrimental, that's too mild a word. Fatal, all over. This is where his dad was governor, his dad was beloved. He lived there for 18 years. Of course, he loves the lakes, he loves the trees, he loves everything about Michigan. He keeps telling us, and it sounds sillier and sillier and sillier every day. He has to win Michigan. Otherwise, write the obit. The political obituary will have to be written.
Well, I would say he has to win his home state. Michigan's just one of five, so if he doesn't win Michigan, he can win another one. On the other hand, he does have to start winning because he's the front runner. He's the front runner who has won the fewest of the front runners in terms of primary. And he's kind of running low on money. You know, everyone's talking about the money. The money's down to $8 million because he spent $19 million on the last couple of cycles. So he's in a position where the whole thing could come apart if he loses Michigan. Because if he loses Michigan, then the next week, Super Tuesday. And he could lose a few there, and he could still have the money in the organization, and the media could still be loving him, but he could totally fall apart as a candidate.
Did Rick Santorum's comments about Satan help him or hurt him?
Absolutely. I'm not sure. I think it actually helps him because he's talking about God. And right now, he's not trying to win any general election. You hear all these pundits talking about, oh, this is going to hurt him in the general election. What him is in the general election? That's never been one of the options. Mitt's the nominee, right? Rick Santorum's trying to steal this thing away. He can't be worrying about any general election. He's got to worry about how can he kidnap this thing from Mitt Romney. And that's what he's trying to do. He's trying to get rid of all the other conservatives and make it him versus Mitt. And you remember, 75% of the voters through this whole cycle have not wanted Mitt. He wants to consolidate those voters into a Santorum campaign.
Santorum's pretty good on this stuff. He really is. Now, the risk he is to Santorum with the Satan comments, the contraception comments, other things. The risk is that, and he knows what the risk is. The media are going to take his comments and distort it. The media is totally in the tank, one for Obama, and two in terms of the social and cultural drift of this country.
It's stunning how deceptive they are.
He stands face first into that wind of the social and cultural disintegration. They don't like it when they're called on it because they're uncomfortable with what they see. The harvest that they have brought to the United States of America is a bitter harvest on these things. And Santorum says it's about time regular Americans push back. Amen, amen, I say to Rick.
I love the metaphors today. You got the wind and you got the bitter harvest. Think about that, and if it makes any sense, send me a postcard.
Two Lynn High School girls were taped by cell phone cameras fist fighting. The video ended up on YouTube, and now city officials are outraged. Should the people who stood by and watched be punished? And should those who taped the fight face penalties as well?
I don't think so. I think we're getting on a slippery slope. We're crossing a line, all those other cliches I like to use, all of that stuff, because why? Because kids gather around whenever any other kids square off. And that's been going on historically. Now that you have these cell phones with cameras and everybody posts it up, really makes no difference. You can't begin to impose responsibility on somebody who's in the playground, and that's where it happened, in a playground, not during school hours or anything else like that, and they're there with their buddies or their friends and two nitwits get into a brawl. Big deal. And you watch the brawl because you want to see who's the best nitwit.
However, Thomas, in the old days, back in the 18th century, when you were in high school, there were no cell phones, all right? So we never think about what's the responsibility of somebody standing there with a phone. They could call for help. They could call an adult. I just think kids are trouble because our culture is being dismantled deliberately, and it's imploding and crumbling and anything you want to describe it. We need to give more power to schools to try to teach kids something about sanity rather than, and they get sued. The schools get sued every time they move.
Here's the slippery slope in the line I just talked about.
In a good direction.
Todd, who says never, ever surrender an iota of individual responsibility and or power to the government.
Says, I don't say
oh,
that.
You need the government here to step in. The school is now going to tell you what to do in the playground. They're going to tell you how to
bunt, like that.
How to advance.
They're children.
Come on.
I don't like children having
friend.
Constitutional rights. Screw them. Don't let them fight. Crack down. That's it for this week's Face Off. We'll see you next week right here at WRKO.com.